Okay, let's try again. After a perfect auto start, started another leak, and I hope this one will be better than the previous one. Okay, we play versus Lurus again, but this hand is actually interesting because like you have like two cards are not doing anything. They may play a land, play strike, and we need to draw a source in two cards to have a tier 3 combo. I think it's an acceptable risk. Let's play. They changed the name to Complain. I complain because like this name is Garbo. Seismic Swans, what the fuck? Okay. May move to 6. This is more interesting because now if we draw a land we can try to land turn to moon. We kinda need to respect that. Also we can just try to discard mincons, assuming they have forces too. In my opinion, the easiest discard is the Spirit Ritual. Because it stops my Fast Moon and my Iron Crack Feet kill. And my turn to Rekros, because it's also a possibility. Mm-hmm, nice. Okay. I really love your streams with combo decks. Can you add some new arrow decks with like Inverter or Dredge Stretch, please? What? Okay, nice forest opponent. Inverter combo, like, I feel that inverter combo was already explored and it... Oh fuck, that's rude. That's rude. But okay. Is it Dead Sea? I assume you are asking about music? I don't know. We can moon them, but mooning won't change anything, so let's just wait for my mana source or ritual. I have to say that my draws aren't very lucky today. We have one lucky top deck, and I'll say that we are on the opposite side of the spectrum. Your wallpaper. Ah, okay, wallpaper. Actually, funny story about my wallpaper. Okay, we drew a land. This is Robert Makłowicz, and when I was doing a house party, a group of my friends saw the computer left unchecked. So I conquered it and changed my wallpaper, and I said that, you know, that's kinda cool. Let's keep it for the future. Okay, we won. Okay, sideboard. Leyline is kinda okay. It's not that as spectacular as people think. Because we have like 6 discard spells and Veil of Summer can also protect my lands and Belcher from Assassin's Trophy, Abrek DK, Colagan's Command, etc, etc. Perfect man body. It's Robert Makłowicz after all. Okay, what we can cut. We can attack my mana, so cutting lands is not an option, especially if we want to cast spiky hazards. Strike is probably the worst, because we can destroy treasures like we saw it earlier. There's a possibility to add Fury, just to kill Ragavan or DRC, but what if they start with discard into Tarmogoyf? Or Heaven Ursa's Fuck, this is something I forgot about it. Okay, Ascension. Ascension play Ascension instead of. Let's take it each, okay. Now we have outs to. To possible Pinny Needle. Okay, this is a turn 3. Let's keep. Tier 3, even with removal, is 1 packed enough versus 4 over control game 1 instead of 2 for Veil of Summer. Versus blue white control, all you need to do is to keep playing your spells and you should win. Because they need to counter your early Blood Moon, they need to counter your Rekros, because Rekros means you have all the Belchers in the world. And you need to, they need to counter your Belchers. So they have 12 counters to 12 cards to counter ASAP. Okay, so we have turn 2 kill now. Let's see if opponent can stop that. And like, matchup versus control is very easy, at least for now. Like, when they add Force of Negations or Stone Silence or something like that, it will be much worse. But for now, I like it. And post sideboard, like, Pact of Negation is the biggest trap in my opinion, because since you have infinite time, you don't need to commit that hard to kill them on one turn. And okay, do you have a discard? You don't. And Pact of Negation means that you need to commit, and it's not that good. Like, Pact of Negation is good versus Murktide, for example, when they don't have Teferi. And, like. Okay, we won. Sorry, opponent. No. Bank. Turn 2. Oh, good. So, Pact of Negation is more as a protection for Pyromancer Ascension line, and maybe it's good versus Baron because of Deflecting Palm. And that's it. And playing one Pact and 4 Veils was a really good meta call. With more Murktide, maybe I would come back to 2-3, or even play 3 Pact of Negations. Okay, why do you think Harriet died with Modern Horizons 2? Huh, that's a good question. Prismatic Ending is a problem, that's for sure, because your Heliot can be killed. Also, a cheap removal is even better with Unholy Hit. So your Mana Dork will die more often. But overall, I think the deck is a bit underplayed, should be played more. Dresden is also a thing, but you know, this is a maybe not narrow, but not very widely played sideboard card, so this shouldn't change that much. Thank you. Tusk has a bad matchup against Hammer. Like, I was thinking this is quite the opposite, because they have only Inkbot Nexus to deal with. Maybe Urza's Saga has changed things, because before Urza's Saga, Hammer was an underdog in the matchup. Also, there's, you know, a strong possibility that Haliot is not played because of clicking and the click fest. No Hammer has a bad matchup against Haliot. Okay, Paper Smoke MTG, thanks for confirming my my take. Keep. I feel that we can start with Balaghet here. Mostly because if I discard my Belcher, I want to have Awakening in event. Also, Balaghet is also a nice thing to cast. Livingant beats 100 of life pretty easy, and otherwise why is them? I was thinking that pretty much. Like, it's Livingant! That's powerful. Okay, okay, we can just deploy Belcher. To play around counter spells. And then, like, we play a Taplan, they can go Teferi, we can... Okay, you can Pact of Negation Teferi, so it's all okay. Gifts and given? Okay, chat, I got tricked. I was playing, thinking that I'm playing versus blue white. Rather so the extreme. Welcome. This exile effect, rude. Seachrom calls Castle Vantress. Well done, opponent. Okay. Now I kinda regret my decisions. Because this battle will be really good on turn 3. Instead of retreat Belcher. Direction. Someone in my chat told me a bit over time, 5 times on Belcher or something. That's true. Like, my final, semi-final, quarter-final, round 7 and round 6 were on our blue-white control. And it was easy. Easy. Because the builds of blue-white control for the weekend were not prepared to beat Belcher at all. Banveil, it wasn't about Veil, it was about Blood Moon. Turn to Blood Moon, like, we didn't have Force of Negation then. And then you like, oh, I have turn to Blood Moon. Let's just win. This was that easy. Oh, another force of negation. Well done, opponent. Well done. Yeah, no, that's the difference. Hey, versus blue-white, we would win twice already. Okay, we have only two cards, though, so... Okay. This man combo got kinda. Thanks for your good word. Okay. Unmarked grave. Okay, so we have only one card. And we discarded two persists, so... Perhaps we want to cast Awakening here, just to draw into Wincons. Okay, at least we have Blood Moon next turn, so into Awakening, trading Arcane Fit into stuff. Okay, you have two cards only. Opponent. You used already two forces. Let's see if you have we have planes. That's rude. Okay, let's still go for Blood Moon. If I go Persis into Archon, this can be problematic. Counterspell, really? Okay, you have zero cards at least. If we top deck Belcher, we win next turn. If we don't top deck Belcher, we can Awakening and try to draw into Belcher. Okay, I was like, did you draw a Persis? Okay, so, okay, Unburial Rites waiting. Okay, chat problems. Recross the paths, hello. So... We go for Archon. Okay, if we tap out for Archon, we win. Timber. I will go for a Reforge pile. If we counter Reforge, then later we... Okay. If they don't do anything, we cast Reforge, they counter, then they go for Unburial Rites. Archon, we discard feed, then we draw another Belcher and win. So go Reforge. And from now we can build a pile. Okay, Belcher on the top. And now we build a pile with Pact of Negation backup. So we have 2 mana, so it will be... land, ritual, 2 reads. This is 7 mana, pact of negation. Mana morph, just in case, if they somehow can counter 2 spells, which is a possibility, has to be said. Maybe going for just Belcher instead of Reforge was safer, and then Reforge. Yeah, that's probably better. Okay, let's not think about it. Okay, so let's later go for Belcher, Feet, and another Belcher. Polluted Delta, okay. Okay, that was expected. I just got iron crack. Just safer because if something that happens, at least we can build another pile with Recross. We won't be able because they will discard my hand, so like a now or never situation. That was close, actually. Okay, two counter spells, two force of negations, beaten. Okay, Veil of Summer, cool. Reforge can go. Iron Crack can go. Ritual can go. Although, Turn to Moon is cool. But it's not that important. Maybe it is. Okay, we can cut one the ritual, one land probably. Oh, okay. Why were we keep Plunge Titan? So if that's the case, we can return the land and we can return or at least side in. Think about Ascension. It's really good versus Seraph Emissary, so let's try it. We have one pact as a backup, so we can maybe try to build the pies, which is the worst card for this deck. Collector of Necromantia. You can play around everything here. So hard to say for me. What is the worst? Okay, let's keep Blood Moon Recross stuff, I would say. You can kill Collector with this. It's not the end of the world if we play it. And with Fury, of course, if you're prepared. About Necromantia, you have Pyromancy, like Chopin, nice choice, thanks. About Necromantia, you can just go for Ascension kill after they exile your Belchers. Like, obviously, playing without Belchers is problematic and can be kinda hard. Okay, another Blood Moon. So you can go Ritual. Blood Moon, they need to counter. Oh, just Cluster here, okay. The Cluster here is easier. To achieve, so they can maybe go for the Fairy. Counter Ritual is quite common, actually. Like, it's one for one, but you capitalize on that, but sometimes, okay, the fairy, I guess. Oh no. Ty kurwa głupia. Okay, that was rude. Okay, phone check. Yes. I go for another Blood Moon just in case. We have time with this Recross. Remember when I said that we do have time? Actually, we do not. What now? We go for Seraph Emissary. Then we can Recross and try to win that way. If we go for Archon, we should be able to recruit them. Arm of Curtis Rasim. Okay. Choose two cards. Okay, I chose two cards. Now I have some decisions to make. Going for Ascension line is probably the safest, but that's one risk. If they counter my Ascension, we are fucked. Unless we build like a pile that has an Ascension but also has way to deploy Belcher. We can also start with Belcher into a Reforged pile with Ascension and Protection. Because we have Feed, Desperate. If we go Seras Emissary, then what? But they would go for it now, so I assume they don't have it. So we probably have counters. We can... okay, they can have Flusterstorm to cast. And Fawns. So going for... this is the first wave to counter stuff. Then we can... oh, we can even Manamorphose into Reforge. What is this game? I'm new here. It's Magic the Gathering Modern. Okay, then now I think we go Reforge pile. And we still, because we have 4 lands, we can just go for Ascension. Then put 3 mana Morphoses. Because if we naturally draw Ascension, we naturally draw Morphoses. Then if we were Ascension, after we... okay, first counter, second counter, mana Morphos will get doubled. So then we go... Ritual Balaget. From there it should be quite easy. Can we go Belcher? Probably not. Then we go Ritual Balaget. Okay, I have one Balaget in play, so it won't work. Then we go another Ritual. Then more mana. Belcher just in case. Okay, let's find Wincons for those 5 with hazards. One smashing because why not? Strike it reach. Fuck, I forgot about Pact of Negation. As in pile. Kurwa, zjebałem. Okay. Yeah, this was bad. They have planes? That's rude. Okay. That was poor, I would say. Because, like, the whole Ascension pile is about that you, after you draw 7, you have Pyromancer Ascension loop with Pact of Negation as a backup. Hey, where are you, Dito? Okay. I haven't seen it in a while. Rude, but winnable from this position. it was close. Okay, 2-0. He's trolling. Like, I think that the lack of any real results for Dido is not trolling. He's calling for help. Aldurem 85. Another guy. Why? What is DP? You reckon Belcher is strong, so the cool. I don't understand this question. Please rewrite it in a way that I can understand it. Okay, this is a turn to moon if we need it. It's a turn. Possible turn 3 win or turn 3 reckless if we draw a source, so I like it. Why do you think Belcher is strong? Because it can kill you on turn 3 quite often, plus it grinds really well. And regular debuffs means that you can deal with hate quite nicely. But it's way better than other combo decks like Storm at Nauseam. Like, it's... One card combos are usually better than more, like, the critical mass combos. Like, at Nauseam is a free card combo. This is a one card combo, essentially. And all other things are not necessary to kill the opponent. You can just have 4 lands, Belcher kill. As easy as that. You have Mind Deck Blood, you have... If I have slots to play reactive cards like Blood Moon, and Blood Moon can win the game by itself very often. Recross the Pass is a combo piece that can also find responses to opponent's hate, which is also extremely cool. And so on. The worst part of this deck is mana, because you have many tap lands and this can be problematic from time to time. But overall, I think that like it's not like this deck is not soft to Chalice. It's playing Blood Moon, not it's soft to Blood Moon. For example, Ad Nauseam is very soft to Blood Moon. It's a Ward Crane combo instead of many card combo. You don't need to overcommit into one play since you are a one card combo. You can just present your card, your game winning card, over and over again. And it's not like you need to spend a lot of resources to... to win the game. This is a similar question. What's better? Storm in Legacy or something strange like, you know, Iggy Pop or whatever? Like, there are fun combo decks and good combo decks, and I feel that Belcher is in the second. Okay, what do you want to deploy here? Red Reunion. Dredge. Opponent, you should play Rainbow Dredge instead of this. It's better. Okay, let's draw Ritual and end this game. Manamorphos. We can go for Recross the Paths. But I'm a bit worried that... I can go Shriekhorn, and then what? It will be quite hard to build a pile that will play around Shriekhorn, so maybe playing Tapland go is safer. should be a bit of a great stretch. No, sadly no. I was hoping that it's a is the case, but it is not. Okay. As easy as that. Okay. That was fun. Sideboarding versus dredge. This is always a big question for me. Blamo Arbat. So as everything else. Leyline can stop discard and can stop conflagrate, which is something. We can have random height to like Pinion Needle or Leyline or Ancient Grudge is also a thing. We can cut this. Maybe we can cut the add Ascension. But Ascension versus Shriekorn is the nightmare to build. And just add Furies then. I'm not sure if I should play Ascension or not, but I don't have many better ideas what to add here. Refuge is a win con for them, yes. They can just dredge to find their needed cheats, so it's not like you mill them. They can just stop dredging. What if you don't fight for the stack and run only Fury? If they dredge too much, of course, but I don't feel it will happen. What if you don't fight for the stack and run only Fury? We can, but the problem is that you can kill, for example, Amalgam Narcomoeba, and if they have their good draws, this won't do that much. Because they will, like, the combination of a bit of damage plus a lot of burn spells will kill you. Like, in this matchup, Dredge is kind of a burn spell. Burn deck, and creatures are just helping them to achieve this plan, because now this means that they will most likely find all of their creeping chills, so you have exactly 8 life. We need to keep it, because we can't not keep this type of hands, but it's not really good. I have a multi 5. It doesn't matter that much for dredge. A multi 4, okay. 4 can be problematic. Show me what you got. Oh. If Family Touch was an instant, it would be a different story then. Okay, more Manamorphoses. With triple Manamorphos draw, Ascension kill can be interesting. Okay, reunion. Nice. Oh, don't have luck, opponent. another Recross. Do you want to try to draw Ritual? I think we should. This is bad, but I think we can play around it pretty well. Okay, now the question is, how do you play around possible Shikorn? If we go for Shikorn, we most likely... Okay, we can use it in two different options. In response to the Miracle on right away to Milwaukee Miracle. I think that we go for right away. So we go Reforge, then we go for Garbo card, for example, Infernal Plunge. Then we go for Belcher. These two, then we draw Belcher, then we can mean again, so something generic like a Ritual would be good, like Retreat. They don't have the Shriek, you don't know it. You haven't seen other worldly guys to say it. Then we go for the land. Feed. More Ritual, more Belcher. Okay, they don't have Shriek in them. Oh, that's a really good flip. Shenanigans? OMG. What a cringe. Shenanigans. Opponent. Lol. To shenanigans! Oh, why, opponent? Why? Why are so poor? And so bad in Game of Magic? Shenanigans. Like, there are not many cards that trigger me so much than shenanigans. For real. Okay, I have gold, cool. Okay, so upkeep cast Pact of the Titan. We upkeep cast Mana Morphos. To draw more cards, because why not? I may dredge a lot, but we can deal us only 12 damage, so it's okay. Shenanigans, nice! Opponent ready. And Ashen Grudge? What? Shenanigans would be good if there was for one mana. But it's, since it's for two, it's Garbo. Don't play it, please. So like you could see, deck can win fast, deck can win through counter magic. I really like it, and I feel this will be my perfect position for the shoot, okay. Can, like, to be honest with you, I don't listen to it actively. For me it's just a... I guess it's war. Background. The ring can also win also versus Shenanigans MG. Yeah. I just don't get it. Ancient Grudge is acceptable because you don't lose tempo. You can destroy strike it reach, etc, etc. But Shenanigans. Please stop. Okay, round 4, we are 3-0. So far, we're gonna die roll, that's cool. Okay, we're playing versus Lurus. So, versus Lurus, this hand is like one ritual away from the win. And you have like two dead cards. You have Belcher in hand, we're gonna play. So, we shouldn't mulligan this type of hands, I guess. So, let's keep. Let's draw ritual. Could be easy. Urza Saga, okay. Looks like hammer to me. Okay, we need this ritual fast. Okay. That was easy. Another Urza Saga, okay. Opponent has a lot of money. Let's act that we don't have everything. Okay, let's play around Malachite. Game one is the where you most often lose versus Hammer, because post side you have 7-0 mana good cards versus them. You cut Moons, you cut Pact, you cut Reforge, you cut one Strike It Rich and Songbird, and you are good to go. Maybe Senic Ascension to Tyrant Hate is reasonable, but I feel that all other cards are better, like Lance are better, Rituals are better, Force, Claim and Fury can work alone, better when drawn, so I'm not that interested in Ascension. Damn, this deck is so dumb, you are so dumb, what? That was so rude, Nishaya. Okay, I didn't want to be rude to you, but like half of this deck is extremely dumb. You play your Belcher pass, it's dumb. But the second half, called Recross the Pass, has very doomsday feels. Okay, let's keep this one. I like this hand. Okay, opponent moves to 5. Let's keep it bottom packed. We have Fury and Force Vigor and Belcher. So I like the position where I am. Okay, Counselet, Country, Yarart, Foxes. That's rude. What would you discard here? Liking dumb decks is the highest level of playing Magic. They discarded Belcher, wrong decision. Okay, Mana Morphosis is great because it will be good versus with both Fury and Force. Okay. Probably want to wait with Fury. Balagad. Balagad means that I can return Belcher one day. Rotopterski, sure. I will most likely just reset the board and they will be with one land, we have three mana sources. Okay, Awakening is great because. Okay, this is an interesting spot. We can play a third land, we can keep Balagad in hand. And what's better here? Okay, so I'm thinking if I want to cast Balagad on Belcher or not. Go Belcher, go Belcher, go Belcher. I feel like the odds to draw a land are quite high, so my Balagad will eventually do the work. They will be very far behind on everything. You can go Fury. We can also cast Balagad now, but we have two lands and we need to top deck a land to do stuff. To go Strike It Rich, then to go Belcher, so it's not like having a treasure means that you can top the characters and win that way. So I feel it that keeping Malakith is fine actually. Okay. Let's go for Fury from Awakening. And pass and upkeep force. Metamorphos. Rotopterski, sure. Okay. It's a nice draw, I would say. Nature's Claim. Cool, cool. So we are in the top deck war, and okay. Do you want to claim the Sigarda site or not? I feel I should, just because of tempo reasons. Maror Topterski. But if I go for the land, then I can return Lurus and then suddenly you can be in trouble later on. Okay, I still feel it's safe to go like this. Metamorphos. Ritual. We can go Ritual Strike it Reach. It's not the worst actually. You have killing two Terrans opponents, what you can present here. More guys. Just Recross. What's better? Belcher or just Recross? We don't have claim already. I think just going Belcher is safer. I'm not safer, but okay, jump. GG's. Okay. For all. Okay, chat, we are fighting for a trophy. I would love to see some hype. Okay, jump block Kami. Block. Blots Kami. Let's go, thanks. 8-0, yeah. Like after our beautiful 0-2. Going 8-0 is kind of fun. Like, also, I'm quite happy that we're playing against different decks, and we lost to kinda random ones, like we lost to Storm. Okay, Frako 9-4, Pog, Mr. Grey Fox, Tiemu, okay, suddenly cool things are happening in the chat. Doomshake, any poggers. I need to have at least one of my emote to be made. One day, chat, one day. Professor French, okay. You want a Dairo, that's cool. They're playing Yorion. And we are playing Nolander. Let's Mulden. Okay, we have turn to Moon versus Yorion deck. Let's keep. Let's bottom Reforge. Nemo, just one trophy? That's actually funny. Like, I had a lot of 4-1s when I was testing, and I was also testing bad versions of Dredge, which took me a length of time. Should I be better to have Redland ready just in case? Okay, let's go for extremely cool magic play. Yes. A lot of four, like, what can I can say? I love Blood Moon. I like playing Blood Moon, but not playing against it when I'm soft to it. Ritual. Like, I feel like I'm not playing 8 wincons, but 12. Okay, we're playing versus cards. This group of Bear Willows means that maybe this is a Doomwakes 4-color Rhinos list with Yorion. So that means that Balmo is kinda good. When you pack like Force of Vigors, we can add Veils to the mix. I don't know if 4 is a good number though. We can cut Plunge Titan to add Veils. But I'm gonna draw, so maybe these fast kills will be needed. Maybe not. Is Pact of Negation good? It is good, yes. Like Pact of Negation is really good versus Rhinos, but that means that you need to very commit to what you are doing. So it's good for the piles. For example, you can go from 3 runs to your Desperate Ritual Splice pile with Belgian and Pact of Negation backup. But it's not actually the best thing ever to do. Okay, we need to cut one more card. I think that Iron Crack can go. I don't want to draw too many of them, and lands are important. Okay, so I like this. I have Veil, Belcher, and things, so let's keep. What matches do we want Ascension on and why? When you can't win with Belcher, then Ascension is good. Ascension means that you can go infinite with everything you have. With mana, draws, and so on. But there are still minuses for Ascension, because you need to commit to your pile to Ascension, and if they... A opponent is also drawing 7 cards, so if they have an address close to Ascension, then your hand is kinda poor. So you know. Okay, more tap lands, why not? Okay, we're playing around Blood Moon, at least we're trying, maybe not trying, but we're representing this. So let's go for Strike. Let's go for Balagut. And next, there we go. Read Belcher with Veil backup. And hope that's enough. Maybe if we draw another Veil, maybe we can think about other lines, for example, Strike it, Reach, go, and then go. OMG, that's rude. That's actually rude. Okay, let's counter your Pretty Theft then. There's another thing about the deck these days is that you don't cascade into Belcher. What? Another ritual. Okay, so can we land, retreat Belcher with Veil backup? Kinda, yes. Let's try that then. Okay. That's rude. But that's not the end of the world because you cast Balaghet and keep the pressure. Your opponent. Viseros, yeah, this is most likely a 4-color Yorion Rhino list. Oh, Pact of Negation, okay, now we are talking, chat. Now we're talking. Cascade. Okay. Okay, you reveal. What? Emrakul, the Aeon Storm. Okay, Nahiri. Okay. Mystical Dispute. Sure. I got Banty Aeon with the French team for beating him. That's actually very, I would say, aggressive move. Endurance in? What? Omnat. Michael Lord told you he makes questionable plays. It's not questionable with Nahiri, because it's a wincon that plays around Cascade Mechanic. I totally understand all rage quitters and ragers because I'm one of them. So, you know. Things happen. Okay. Omnat. Sure. Dragon Legion makes me feel safe here. Opponent is losing life. Sure. Robots of mana. Petty Theft. Probably safer to fail now. Woohoo! Tenno!